Let's talk Tanya for the first of Kislev, Rosh Chodesh Kislev. In yesterday's Tanya, the Alter Rebbe spoke about davening without kavana, that when a person davens without kavana, so then the davening doesn't go up to heaven at all. And he brings sources from that from the Zohar. And as we've mentioned, when we started Kuntas Achron, the part of the function or the purpose of Kuntas Achron is the Alter Rebbe resolving various areas in Kabbalah which seem to contradict each other in pertaining to the topics that we talk about in Tanya. So here also the Alter Rebbe says, well, there's another place in the Zohar where it seems that when a person davens without kavana, it does go up. And the Alter Rebbe resolves the contradiction and says, yes, it goes up, but it goes up to what is known as Malchus Da'asiya, which is the lowest level of the lowest world, or the lowest level of the lowest heaven. And because that is the direct source of this world, the fact that the prayer goes up over there, the davening goes up over there, so essentially, it didn't transcend the world. We can't say that it went up to the heavens. It just goes up to the source of the world in the spiritual worlds. Then the Alter Rebbe brings another place where it says that actually, when a person davens without kavana, the davening goes up all the way to the world of Bria, which is a pretty high spiritual world. And the Alter Rebbe says that's a different type of aliyah. It's a different type of ascending. Because sometimes when something goes up to heaven, it's not because it's there to unite with the holiness over there, but actually it's over there to cause damage over there. So you don't confuse that. When we're saying it doesn't go up, it means it doesn't go up to do anything positive. Yes, actually, davening without kavana could go up to do damage in the higher worlds. And then the Alter Rebbe in today's Tanya, he transitions back to Torah study without kavana, which, if you remember, we said that as opposed to davening without kavana, which the davening does not go up, when a person studies Torah without kavana, it does go up. It goes up to the world of Yetzirah and it creates angels. And the reason why we explain this is because there's nothing blocking the Torah from going up. And the Torah brings an interesting proof for this. We know that the Talmud tells us that there is something very special about the Torah study of children before the age of Bar and Bas Mitzvah. It's known as Hevel She'ein Bechit. The Torah comes from breath that has no sin because children don't have any sins because they're not obligated in the mitzvahs. So therefore, what do we see over here? That the Talmud tells us there's something special about this Torah because there's nothing blocking it from going up. Because you have to understand, when a child is learning Torah, he doesn't have the proper lishma, he doesn't have the proper motivation of love for Hashem and awe for Hashem. In all probability, the reason why the child is studying Torah is because they're in school and they're worried that the teacher will discipline them if they don't study properly. So even though they don't have the proper kavana, but because there's nothing blocking it, there is no sins over there, it can go up to the higher worlds and actually it can sustain all of our world with the merit of that Torah study. So the same concept applies also when we study Torah. As long as there's nothing blocking it, even if we don't have the proper kavana, it still could go up and create angels in the world of Yetzirah. Although definitely that's not as ideal as studying Torah with kavana, which then the Torah goes even higher. And as we said, also it unites with the godliness in the world, not only creates angels. So with this, we finished this chapter. And the takeaway from this chapter is how important kavana is. You know, we tend to think, you know, the main thing is the deed, and that is true. The main thing is the deed, because if you don't do the deed, there's nothing. But at the same time, along with the deed, along with the mitzvah, along with the davening, along with the learning, it's important to take the time to focus oneself and focus one's mind and focus one's heart and do the mitzvah with the proper motivation, that of love for Hashem and of awe for Hashem. Tomorrow we will start a new chapter in Kuntas Achron, quite a long chapter, and we'll be diving deeper into the unique functions of davening, of learning, and of actually doing action mitzvahs.